So let's now kind of get into the business. So you started working with your dad. It's this kind of supply chain, fastener-related business, very different from what you were doing before. You mentioned you encountered a lot of different challenges. What kind of challenges, like when you think about the business side, what were some of the biggest challenges that you just remember as being like, wow, these are really, really big issues that were maybe I'm not equipped for or that are just hard for us? What kind of stands out for you? What do you remember from those times?
So yeah, I have a word for it now. I didn't then. There were no systems. And again, this is like storybook fallacy. I'm looking back with what I know now. I grew up building Legos. I grew up with this idea that everything had a place and only one place. That's natural to me. And so for me, watching them work in this business, I was like, there's so many places they can make mistakes and transcribe wrong, and there's no set form. And like, they have to kind of make this up every time that they do it. They have to decide what to write down. And the sheer amount of information was overwhelming, and no structure to put it in made it even worse. So for me, that was like the biggest first thing is like, what the hell is going on here? And how are we going to make sure that we are at least doing what we're supposed to be doing, let alone add to it, grow, all that stuff? So my first thing I did was create an ISO manual. And so ISO is basically ISO 9000. It's a common standard that a lot of companies use to kind of basically check your customer requirements, your quality, and it basically says what you'll do. And I did that, but then I also expanded it to a whole process manual, a whole asset list, how to operate all the assets. I basically wrote the manual on how to run this entire business from box crusher all the way to complex sales and negotiations, which allowed me to better understand what's happening and kind of launch the next 4 years of improvements that we worked on, and also kind of helped me learn a lot of terminology around the way that I thought and be able to use it better. So once I understood that I was viewing the world through systems mindset, I was able to read books on systems thinking and get those tools, which made a lot of sense to me, right? So I read Thinking in Systems, and I read the Systems Bible, and on there it talks about systems and complexity, and then it talks about feedback loops. So then I basically said, oh, this is the lens that I naturally believe in, that I view the world through. Now I have this giant toolbox I didn't even know existed to fold back over on my world and make
And Josh,
adjustments.
what would be one example that you think might resonate with a consultant, where there was a problem, there was no system, you built a system around it, and the result you saw by then having that system? What would be something that, again, would probably resonate with a consultant listening right now?
Yeah, so consulting is huge because a lot of it's qualitative, right? It's conversational. But what you'll find, if you want to scale a consulting business, this is my opinion, you cannot do everything that you're able to do. So I know how to do a lot of things, but you're all over the place and you don't scale. You end up doing a little bits of everything. Once you can figure out like the one thing, like this is the guy I'm going to be the X guy, right? Once you have that, now you can actually standardize your initial onboarding conversations, your sales conversations. So I had, not at the beginning, but by the end, I had, this is the work I like doing. This is the work I'm good at. This is the work that brings in a high fee. That means I need to know these 20 things up front. Now your conversations go from, well, tell me about the business and what about these very kind of wishy-washy, you're just kind of trying to become their friend almost, to, hey, I'm going to ask you 20 questions. We're going to run through this, and it's going to give me an idea how many employees, give me their breakdowns on if they're warehouse or front office. You have a reason you're asking these. It gives you confidence. It makes you look more professional to the potential customer. The close is much easier because it's like, wow, he came in, he knew what to ask, and we're already fired up. I mean, just creating just a questionnaire alone, I think, solves my problem, their problem, and my future problems when I'm doing consulting.
Yeah, no, you're definitely speaking our language, and we're big believers in that. I think that's a very powerful example. Did you have any pushback?